We'd like to acknowledge the traditional custodians of the land this house is built on, the Ngunnawal and Ngambri people of the Canberra region, and we pay our deep respects to elders past, present and emerging. Welcome to the Waramanga Rammed Earth House. My name is Travis, and along with my wife Sophie, thanks for clicking and having an interest in our sustainable house. This house was completed in July 2018, built on a block of about 700 square metres in suburban Canberra. The block has a northerly orientation to the rear, sloping down to the rear as well. It was built by 360 Building Services on a design from Architecture Republic, and we want to thank those two groups for their support in coming up with what we think is a fabulous house. For those in the Canberra region, this was a Mr. Fluffy block where the previous house was demolished due to loosefill asbestos, and we had the opportunity to purchase a block in our region in an established suburb. It's nearly 200 square metres of living with three bedrooms over two floors, and we're fortunate that this house has won a number of awards over the last few years, particularly the ACT Southern New South Wales HIA Green Smart Sustainable Home of the Year, and the Building Designers Association National Chris Reardon Award for Residential Sustainable Building in 2019. And the house has reached an 8.8 star on the national rating scheme. Four features I wanted to take you through today in this presentation: solar passive design, insulation and thermal mass, natural and recycled materials, and of course, this being an all-electric home. This design is really built around maximising the northerly aspect of the block, and we bought the block specifically for that aspect. All the living areas face north to the backyard, and there's minimal east-west glazing, really focused on adding the maximum solar gain through winter and minimising the solar gain through summer. The eave lengths were designed to do exactly that, and as you can see, we have built a pergola with shade cloth that minimises the solar gain during summer. Since this photo was taken, we've grown a range of grapevines up over the pergola and hope perhaps in a couple of years that they will replace the shade cloth as the main source of shading on the northerly side. Like most sustainable housing, insulation and thermal mass is really critical. This house is well insulated. You can see the Proclima wrap on the outside of the building. See the tape that seals that up to ensure that it is as airtight as possible. It's well insulated throughout, R5 in the ceiling, all the external and internal walls and between floors are insulated, as is the slab. A feature for us and a key area of investment was in triple glazed timber aluminium windows, very efficient windows, low maintenance on the outside, but with a beautiful timber feel on the inside. And each is fitted with honeycomb blinds that fit within the window recess to ensure the most efficient possible way of minimising heat loss during wind. This is a very high thermal mass house, and we find that makes a great deal of difference to the comfort of living inside this house. It has rammed earth walls, which you can see in the photo here, are 300 millimetres thick, solid mix of gravel and dirt and small amounts of concrete, which really add that thermal mass to the house along with the slab. In winter, it generally doesn't get below 19 degrees downstairs, and in summer, it hardly gets, you know, above 25 degrees downstairs. So a very, very comfortable temperature with no air conditioning in the lower areas. In fact, there's no heating. The heating in this house is hydronic heating, and that runs in the afternoons. There's no heating from about 4 o'clock in the afternoons onwards, right through the course of the year, and it stays lovely warm. The natural and recycled materials, really, the house really was designed around featuring rammed earth, and the rammed earth is built as a spine throughout the main parts of the house. As you can see here, it's the internal spine of the house. It is internal only. You can get it external, but we didn't want to try and have to work out how to put insulation and other thermal breaks within the material, so we've kept it as an internal material only. It's built on site. It's one of the first things that is built once the slab has gone down, with the material sourced from a quarry maybe an hour and a half south of Canberra. Really high thermal mass, as I mentioned before. I know that many round birth houses can be structural. This case, it's non-structural, with all the structural beams captured within plasterboard walls that adjoin these rammed earth walls. You can see here the process of construction with, on the right-hand side, the forms that are used to build the walls. Each of these built on site with the rammed earth poured into those forms and hammered down with a pneumatic ram. They build them right up to the full finished wall height, leave it overnight, and then strip the forms. And you can see that on the left. And that is essentially the finished product, with a small amount of detailing to fill a few holes and a small sealant. That is the finished product that we have in our house now. And it is beautifully tactile and warm and organic and inviting. And anytime a visitor comes, they always need to put their hands on the wall to see how it. This here is the finished product. You can see smooth, non-dusty, and lovely and warm. As well as the rammed earth, the house features natural other recycled materials. So these are recycled bricks from Melbourne factory demolitions. The house also features a range of recycled black butt timber sourced from housing demolitions, particularly in Sydney, for the internal stairs and balusters, and spotted gum for the decking and pergolas and things like that. So recycled timber used throughout all the main kind of living areas. This house is an all-electric house, and that was a deliberate decision taken right at the start of our process to not have gas connected to the property. It's supported by a 9.6 kilowatt solar PV system and a 10 kilowatt LG battery with the reposit virtual power station to maximise its efficiency. Our electricity consumption is around 12 kilowatts in summer and around 23 in winter, which is largely driven by the heating needs. But as you can see from this graph in the middle, this was for about a year ago, and it the energy use is largely supported by the solar that we have on our system. Obviously, rainy and cloudy days, not so much, but for 99% of the year, we are energy sufficient. All our appliances are electric. We have Bosch in slab hydronic heating. We have in the lower areas, which is generally enough heating for the entire house. So while we have a Daikin split system upstairs, that's generally used only in summer for cooling. And that's only been a late addition to our house. Ceiling fans throughout, and they make an enormous difference to the comfort levels of the house, along with windows that are tilt and turn so we can purge the warm air from the house quickly over summer. Induction heating and a sand and hot water system here, which even in Canberra's chilly climate has proved to be plenty for our family of four. I'd like to thank you for listening in today. Very happy to take any questions, and thanks very much to the Sustainable House Day sponsors. It's a great event, and we're really pleased to be supporting this event again this year. Thank you very much.